everyone. Welcome to Upper Room. I know it's a little barren right now, but it does fill up in the next 15 minutes. We're actually at the end of Upper Room, or during a certain time. A lot of the leaders from Alpha, we're doing Alpha Retreat tomorrow at Christ the King, but a few of the parishes, their leaders are going to come over and pray with us, so that would be a really beautiful blessing. Is anyone new to Upper Room tonight? Anyone? Well, welcome. And I just want to welcome all the people that are coming on the live stream, that we're really happy that you're here. And for those that are new, Upper Room is a charismatic prayer meeting that's just open to the Holy Spirit, the joy of the Lord, the gifts of the Spirit, freedom in the Holy Spirit, all of those good things. And we really have seen and witnessed, like, really God moving at Upper Room, people being physically healed, spiritually healed, emotionally healed, people experiencing new life in the Holy Spirit. That's just what's amazing about Christ the King. There's just such an anointing on this parish. So whether you're here in person or watching it at home, like, the Lord wants to bless you, okay? And as you know, we're in a season of Lent. It's not my favorite season, but I know there's a good reason for it. But it's a time of, like, sacrifice and fasting, really looking within our hearts, right? Trying to get rid of the sin in our lives. But the beauty of Lent is that it predisposes us to receive more from the Lord, right? And it reminds me of a beautiful scripture, Hosea 2:14. Behold, I will allure her. I will lead her into the desert and speak to her heart. And that's what the Lord wants to do tonight. He wants us to come to him. He wants us to worship him. He wants us to repent for the things that are keeping us from him. And then he wants to speak to our hearts. He wants to fill us with joy. He wants to heal us. He wants to give us again more freedom. So I just invite you to be open to that. And if you're watching online, just if you open up YouTube chat, you could, like, there's like a little community there where you could share intentions or prophecies, or just say hi. We'd love to hear from you. So we're just going to open up with a prayer. In the name of the Father, Son, the Holy Spirit, amen. Jesus, we just invite you here to fill Christ the King Church with your Holy Spirit, that you would fill our hearts with more power, more love, more gifts, more freedom, Jesus. Lord, we pray that in this time of Lent that you would help us to turn to you, Lord, that we would turn away from the things that distract us from you, that lead us away from you, and that, Jesus, we would truly come towards you, Lord, and change our direction, Jesus, that we could be filled more with you. And we ask this in Jesus' name, amen. So we're just going to go and enter into worship, worshiping the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
All right. Why don't we all stand? That's right. There we go. And let's just take a minute, and we're just going to kind of sing out whatever welcome we have to the Lord. Just ask the Holy Spirit to come and be with us. Holy Spirit, come and fill this place.
Adore you, the King.
8, shower, O heavens from above, and let the skies rain down righteousness. Let the earth open, that salvation may sprout forth, and let it cause righteousness to spring up also. I, the Lord, have created it. We have Revelation 7:16. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more. The sun shall not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb in the midst of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of living water, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Jesus, we just ask you to come, Lord. Come. Fill this place, Lord. Fill this house, Lord, with your power, Lord. Shower us, Lord, with your spirit. Jesus, Jesus.
Stand. step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see beauty that made this heart.
There's a prophetic word that came online. It says, "Oh, my children, let nothing disturb you. Let nothing trouble you. There is much that distracts you, but I tell you, I am here with you in the wind and the rain. The deep longing of your heart can only be filled by my great love for you. Keep your eyes on the cross." It carries on. So Jesus, we just thank you, Lord, and we just invite you, Lord, to come into our hearts, come into our troubles. And Lord, we just invite you, Lord, to just say those words that you said in the storm, peace be still. Let your love just flood over us. Help us to keep our eyes on you. Help us to encounter you more deeply. And Jesus, we just pray for your anointing on the rest of this prayer meeting, that you would just come in a new and beautiful way. Amen. So, Father, who heard Father Ed's homily this past weekend? It was a good one. In his homily, he referenced Revelations 2, and he really called us to and asked us a question: have you lost your first love? And so I'm just going to read this scripture. It touched me so deeply, and it stayed with me that I really felt like the Lord wanted me to like break it open a little more during Upper Room. So it says, Revelations 2, the one who holds the seven stars in his right hand and walks in the midst of the seven gold lampstands says this: I know your works, your labor, and your endurance, and that you cannot tolerate the wicked. You have tested those who call themselves apostles but are not, and discovered that they are imposters. Moreover, you have endurance, and you have suffered for my name, and you have not grown weary. Yet I hold this against you. You have lost the love you had at first. Realize how far you have fallen. Repent and do the works you did at first. Otherwise, I will come to you and remove your lampstand from its place unless you repent. And brothers and sisters, I was like, been really like meditating on this, you know? And the Christians that he is talking about are Christians who love the Lord, okay? It's not just like these are Christians who do ministry. These are Christians who stand up for truth in a culture of death. These are Christians who proclaim the gospel. These are Christians who have suffered persecution by their family and friends and job. These are Christians who've been steadfast all their lives and been faithful and choose the good and what's holy, right? So like, I think these guys are doing pretty well. my estimation, I would say, good job, you know? But then God gives a zinger, you know, and he has a way of doing that. He gave a little zinger, and he's like, it's not enough. It's not enough. And he says, yet I hold this against you. You have lost the love you had at first. And whenever I read this scripture, it just cuts to my heart. And the first thing I think of is, what was the love I had at first, right? When was I passionately in love with Jesus Christ the most in my life? And I always am brought back to my experience was the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And if you've never heard of what baptism of the Holy Spirit is, it's an encounter of God's love that just fills you, overwhelms you, transforms you. You are not the same than you were before. Something happens. And because when God loves touches us, it transforms us. And I thought about that time, and I thought about how passionately in love I was with Jesus Christ. You know, I was at that time in my life, I was really moving in the wrong direction, you know, in many areas. I was at college, first year of college, partying, not living for Christ, very confused, wasn't sure even if I believed in God anymore, very far from God. But one day I cried out to God. I said, God, if you're real, if you're really real, and you show me you love me, I will give everything to you. And I meant that. I was like, I don't care if you call me to Africa. I don't care if you call me to be a nun. I don't care anymore. I just need to know you're real, and I want to follow you. I'm tired of the drinking. I'm tired of the emptiness. I just need to know you're real. And because God loved me and God loves us so much, when we cry out to God from the depths of our heart, He can't help but hear that prayer. And through different things, going to reconciliation, and shortly afterwards, experiencing this baptism of the Holy Spirit. I mean, when I experienced, first of all, forgiveness for my sins, and then experienced the Holy Spirit and experienced His love, all I wanted to do is love God back. I was all in. I started praying, using scripture. Scripture became alive. I started going to daily mass. The Eucharist became more alive. I started to like get rid of the sins in my life. I got rid of my fake ID that my dad actually got me so I could drink in college. And I got rid of my fake ID, and I got rid of my boyfriend who my father didn't give me, but I got rid of him because he was bad news too. And I got rid of all these things, and I started seeking the Lord and hungering for the Lord. And I remember at that point, I was like, I will do whatever you want, God. Whatever you want, I just want to get to heaven. And my perspective and my perception of life and the lens I was looking through life was just completely different. So that, I think, is what God means when He says, have you lost your first love? He wants us to be passionately in love with Him. He doesn't want to take second place. This brings me to the second thing. Oh, wait, sorry. I'm going to say this. Just some questions to ask ourselves if we have lost our first love. Do we have like a prayer life anymore? You know, have we lost that? Do we make excuses? Like, well, I'm a mom, I'm busy. I believe I make that excuse all the time. I have 5 kids, you know. But these are excuses. Have we stopped making time for God in a prayer time? Do we yearn for God above all things, even above our kids, even above the things that are most important to us? Do we prioritize God first in our day? Do we hunger and thirst for the Word of God, for the sacraments? Which brings me to the next part of the scripture. Repent and do the works you did at first. So the scripture is interesting. It talks about two firsts, right? It talks about the love of God you had at first, and it talks about the works you did at first. And these two things are so connected, right? Because when you are in love with Jesus Christ, your works are going to look different, right? They should look different. If you're madly in love with Jesus, you're going to just have an openness. The works you do is going to have a blessing, an anointing. It's going to have power. But I thought to myself, what distinguishes the Christian that God talks about that's being faithful, that's really has endurance and living their faith, and the works of the person that's newly found the faith and is passionate about Christ? What distinguishes these two people? And I remember I went back to when I was passionate about God. I said yes to everything. I wasn't afraid, because perfect love drives out all fear. And when you are filled with perfect love, you don't have fear. So when God tells you to go heal someone on the airplane, you pray over someone for healing on the airplane, okay? And when God says, say this to so-and-so, you say this to so-and-so. And as I was doing this, when I was 19 years old, 20 years old, God would do miracles, right? And I was just like so excited, and I was just obedient. And I think what the difference is that reckless abandonment to God's love. That's why the Lord says, you know, the children will enter the kingdom of God. When you see the teens of Christ the King, you see a fire in them. You see a fearlessness in them. We can learn a lot from them, because they have perfect love, and that increases faith, and they just step out in faith. So God is calling us to get back to that. I remember a few weeks ago, I was at the retreat here for women. And I was really in deep prayer during adoration. And I was just like, you know, pouring my heart out and, you know, doing a repenting and asking the Lord for freedom and all this stuff. And then right before they're about to, reposition, these big words, they sometimes get me sometimes. Anyway, reposition the Blessed Sacrament, the Lord told me, I want you to pray with this girl next to you. And that woman was Mary Two. I don't know if you know Mary Two, but she's suffered from, I got permission to tell, you know, she suffered from seizures. For the last few years, every 6 months, she has a seizure. It's really been debilitating, very hard for her as a mom of five. She's a young mom. Very difficult to go through this. I wasn't thinking anything about Mary too when I was praying before the Blessed Sacrament. But like the Lord broke into my prayer and said, pray for healing for Mary too. And I was like, oh yeah, she has those seizures. Okay, God. So I turned to Mary. I'm like, Mary, I'm going to pray over you for healing. And I put my hand on her back and started praying. Well, we were doing the prayers at benediction, all the prayers at the end of, so I didn't really pray out loud. But afterwards, when I saw her, I felt like the Lord was like, I want you to tell Mary what you prayed for. So I went over to her and I just shared with her, like, I prayed in the name of Jesus, you'd be healed. And I prayed for this and this and that. And she just started crying. She's like, I'll tell you, Caroline, during adoration, right before you prayed with me, I said, God, it's so hard for me to ask you to heal me. But I am putting my trust in you, and please send someone to come to me and pray over me for healing. She goes, and then you looked at me and said, I'm praying over you for healing, and put your hand on my back. See, we need to be disposed to God's voice. We need to be able to hear him. We need to be able to have reckless abandon and to do the works we did at first. And I'll tell you guys, like a few years ago, I probably would have said no. Because you know what? I'm 52 years old. I've had a lot of hurt, a lot of pain. There are times I stepped out in faith and things didn't maybe work out right or whatever, disappointments. And in that, I started pushing God away. I started saying no to different little things. Oh, no, God, no, this person's okay. No, that, I don't know about that, you know. And in time, you know, what happens is the more you say yes to God, the easier it is to say yes to God. But the more you say no to God, the easier it is to say no to God. And what happens in time when you say no, the fire starts to fade. It starts to get weaker, and or we start to stop hearing. We stop hearing the Lord. It's not that God doesn't try. But the beautiful thing is God calls us back. See, that's the beautiful thing. Even if that story is your story, even if you're like, yeah, I've kind of gotten lukewarm. I have been really complacent in my faith. It's okay. That's the beautiful gift. He calls us back. He calls us to repentance. He gives us new life. He calls us to step out again. And that's what we need to do tonight. So I'm going to invite us in a moment. Deacon Pete's going to bring out the Blessed Sacrament. And we're going to pray through and worship a little bit. And then we're going to take a time of repentance, asking the Lord to forgive us for the ways that we have not had him as our first love, and not saying yes to the Lord in a deeper way, and ask God to fill us again. How does that sound? So let us prepare ourselves for adoration.
We fall down.
Calls us to repentance, and what true repentance is turning away from our sin, from anything that keeps us from God. It's not enough to just say, I'm sorry, but it's being sorrowful that moves us to action, that moves us to get rid of the things in our lives that cause us to sin, and to turn back to Jesus. And the Lord may be calling us to repent for complacency, distraction. It could be a lie that you believe that's prevented you from saying yes to God. So I just invite you to close your eyes. Just ask Jesus, when have I lost the love I had at first? Just ask Jesus to show you what you need to repent of. Maybe it's been at times that you've said no to Jesus. Allow the Lord to just speak to your heart. Just repent of that. Say, Jesus, I repent of, for me, it would be allowing my fear to prevent me from saying yes to you. It's just in your heart, just repent of those things the Lord has revealed to you. Some of you may feel like shame or the feeling is like probably shame, but the Lord is calling you to freedom. He is so much joy when we can name what's causing us to sin or is causing us to stumble or not fully love Him and turn back to Him. It gives Him so much joy. So He's saying, do not, no more shame. I died for that. I'm inviting you to freedom. I'm inviting you to repentance. I'm inviting you to new life. And Holy Spirit, I just pray that you would just fill us with, again, a new joy and a new freedom in you. Lord, help us to live as free children of God, that we would be just open to saying yes to you, whatever you call us to do. Remove any slave of fear, slave to fear, or slave to sin, or anything like that. Jesus, we just pray for full freedom. I just want to invite you, as we enter in to deeper worship of the Lord, I invite you, if you would like to come up close to Jesus, you are, please come close to him. He loves you. If you want to continue praying for freedom or repentance, that's good. However the Lord leads you, but I want to welcome you to come close if you feel called to do that.
Just gone through the motions. I'm sorry.
captured my heart, Jesus. Captured my heart. Jesus. Jesus, no lesser love, no idol.
The prophetic word that came online. Know, my beloved, that even when your first love for me waned, I was there with you. While I was not first in your thoughts, you were and always are first in my thoughts. I never left you. I will not leave you. I came for you. You are my beloved. You are precious to me. I love you. Deacon Pete is going to lead us in benediction.
Tantum ergo sacramentum. You have given them bread from heaven, having all sweetness within it. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you gave us the Eucharist as a memorial of your suffering and death. May our worship of this sacrament of your body and blood help us to experience the salvation won for us and the peace of the kingdom, where you live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Together, let us pray the divine praises. Blessed be God. Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God in his angels, and in his saints.
We're going to keep worshiping, so just want to encourage you to take whatever posture you'd like right now.
Let the King of my heart be the mountain where I run, the fountain I drink from. Oh, he is my song. Let the King of my heart be the shadow where I
Running after me.
Brother Ed here?
No. Okay.
That's okay. Oh, he is here. Father, you go around this whole church. I can't know. Usually over there. Could you come and give us a special blessing? And Father, we have some guests here that were getting trained for prayer ministry for Alpha tomorrow. If we want to say a little prayer for them too.
One of the greatest gifts we can give to Jesus is to let him use us to bring other people to him. So would all the folks that are here from Alpha, please like raise your hand. And those around who want to aim at them, just call on Jesus' blessing so that they have lots of love and truth to be able to share with those around them. Hallelujah, Jesus. Lord Jesus, we thank you for the great gift that Alpha is. We ask you, Lord, to draw hungry hearts to come to know in you and love you, and bless all those who are working with Alpha, that they may accompany these people precious to you more deeply into your sacred heart. We ask this, Jesus, in your most precious name. Amen. If nothing else happens in your life during this Lent except that you're fully restored to your first love, it'd be a great Lent. But, you know, the temptation when we hear expression about our first love is to immediately fall into guilt, shame, sadness, resentment, despair. And the devil hands us a magnifying glass and invites us to look at all the ways in which we've lost the first love. And just a reminder that Jesus never calls us to look at our failures. He calls us to look at him. So, if you discover that there might be a minor discrepancy between where you are right now and your first love, then look at the face of Jesus. Because if you look at the face of Jesus, what you'll see is a smile on the face of the King and the clear assurance that he's got this. He alone can restore, and he will. So let us pray. Jesus, I thank you for my sisters and brothers and the love you have for them. I thank you that every time you look at each one of them, you see a son or a daughter you delight in. Help them, Lord, to come closer and closer to you. Fill them with more of that fire of the Holy Spirit, that they may truly fall ever more deeply in love with you. And because you love them so much, we commend them to the care of the great Mother of God, the protection of Saint Michael, the intercession of Saint Joseph. May your peace and blessing rest on them now. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I think we should all express our gratitude to Carolyn for a great sharing tonight.
All right, so our next upper room is pretty exciting. There's a few things going on. Dr. Mary Healy's coming here. We're going to really focus the night on physical healing, healing of all sorts, but mostly physical healing. Then we're going to have a children's workshop before upper room, and we're going to teach them how to pray for healing. We did that a couple of years ago before COVID, and our kids are hungry because when I put it on Facebook, people like, my kids have been asking for 2 years. So we've done this before at Upper Room. It's so amazing how the Lord uses children because of their beautiful, pure faith, like I was talking about. So they're going to be praying over people for physical healing. So invite your friends, people to come. The Lord wants, again, to give us freedom in every area of our lives. And physical healing, God could do in a second. So come, and if you want your children to participate in the workshop, you can sign up. There's links online on the Christ the King page and the Facebook page. And I just want to thank Kelly Burns and the whole music team. It was so anointed, so beautiful. There were times, Kelly, I couldn't I was like, I can't, am I leading this thing? No, I'm really so, it's, I was like crying, giving my heart to God. I'm like, oh, I have to actually get that mic at some point. But it was so beautiful. It was like going into the throne room. And I want to thank the digital ushers and all the people that were working on with the prophetic words. So, all right, let's end with one last song.
All right, you guys want to stand again? There you go. You stood before creation, eternity in your hand. You spoke.
Thank you. Have a great night.